just heads up, I am recording this race in Forza.
30 seconds.
Gotcha. I don't really have anything interesting to say. I'm just playing Magicraft in the background, which is like a roguelite thing. I won't say anything funny.
Great work.
I'm listening to Yogg's Cast Trouble in Terrorist Town in the background because I'm a 5-year-old.
I got you. I don't know what the tire strategy is here. It's like a 20-minute SRS race. I don't know if we need to pit or not. I qualified on pole, which is nice, by like a whole second. In the Group C at Brands Hatch we're doing.
Nice.
The custom set I built for the car handles great, but it handles great for Forza. It's not something I would regularly play, so I'll probably just run this race and be like, oh, okay. That is an eclectic mix of Group C cars, spanning like 6 different years and 2 continents. It's not really how that works. I don't know how much fucking fuel and tire I need. Feature is 15 laps. Tire wear is on 4X, so do I need hards? Guess I don't. We'll see. But it means I have to nurse them, so that's kind of cool. Anyway, we're on pole in a 13-car grid, which is not terrible for what would be close to European prime time. I have no idea how this is going to go. Load times here. Come on, homie. I believe in you. It's a little egregious. There we go. Running the black silhouette Mazda 787B. Already almost 2 seconds ahead in one lap.
Go.
Thank you. halfway through the race. Tires are holding up okay.
Good.
Even though they're on 4X wear. I'm holding off a guy in a Sauber C9. Which I would not expect to do in a 787B, consider it wasn't even in the same car class. Like, when people look into the history of these cars, the 787B was technically in the C2 class. A lot of people forget that. Got behind me wrecked. Thank you. tire wear.
Yeah.
Seems like the other guy wrecked again, too. The race is not close. So we had 13 people signed up for a race like this in Forza. It's really not bad.
Yeah.
At least in my opinion. But, like, it's the Forza crowd, so, like, the gap is just completely lopsided.
Rip.
Yeah.
Go! Wow!
Moderate tire wear. Free to go.
Two to go. Oh my god.
Okay. Dude, there's like canned spinouts in this.
Yeah, it's not that surprising.
That's a joke.
Doesn't mean it's surprising. Thank you.
you supposed to win that race without pitting? Because I did.
Could be. You never know.
That was goofy. And I wrecked it, too. Like, I came off of 2 at Brands Hatch, and I wasn't even really on the throttle. And it just looped on exit, and I was like, okay.
Just because the tires were cooked?
Yeah, and it was, like, fake. Like, it felt fake in the car. It just went, you know? It's like the hand of God just said, no, you're going around.
Oh, my God, he got the God hand technique. He's such a drifter.
These results are a little funny. I'm a level 22. Second place was level 814.
Okay.
Third place was level 974.
Yeah.
What the hell? And that's driver level, too. Holy shit. I don't think I was supposed to win that one.
Some people have too much time on their hands.
Yes, for those watching this when I upload this on YouTube, the load times are real. The video hasn't crapped out or anything. Dude, it's going to take like 45 seconds to display the podium scene. This is pathetic.
Great.
Yeah. And you can hear the cars like racing around in the background too. It's just not showing me anything. Come on, game, I believe in you. There we go. Yay. Awesome textures. Yeah, I made $70,000 from that. That is not a lot of money in this game. These are real loading times, too. Still just GT and touring cars, cool. My rating barely went up from that. How do you beat someone who's level 800 and like 70 something? Your rating goes up like 50 points. Maybe that's not the way to do it. Anyway, I should show my car setup. People are gonna want to know what I ran. Duding? Or just pause the video when you're watching it back. Oh, I didn't have the good sway bar package in. That's not good. That is not what I ran in this car, but okay. Whatever. Fun.